SpaceX has officially announced the launch date for its 12th flight, generating excitement and anticipation for the significant advancements to come in the Starship initiative. What developments does SpaceX have in store? And what big plans will be unveiled on the 12th flight? Let's discuss all of that in today's episode of NR Studio. Nearly a month has passed since the 11th Starship flight, and of course, attention is now focused on the upcoming milestone, Flight 12. With Flight 11 launching on October 13th, there are still more than 2 months left in the year, leading many, myself included, to hope that we might see another Starship launch before the year is out. This launch was anticipated to introduce the highly anticipated V3 version of the vehicle, which would have provided an exciting end to 2025. Unfortunately, that doesn't appear to be the case. SpaceX Vice President of Launch Kinko Donyev has confirmed that Starship 12 will likely launch in January 2026. This announcement definitively ends the possibility of another Starship launch in 2025. While this may be disappointing for fans, it also marks a significant milestone in the program's development. The timeline for Starship will now be more clearly defined, with V1 representing the early development phase through late 2024, V2 reflecting progress made in 2025, and V3 beginning in 2026. According to internal estimates, the next significant version, V4, could potentially launch as early as 2027. The delay appears to be largely related to hardware readiness. The Super Heavy launcher, labeled B18, has not yet begun its testing phase. Recent information indicates that its forward section has been equipped with an improved hot staging ring, but it has not yet been transported to the launch pad. Kinko Donyev stated that this is expected to occur within days to weeks. After that, B18 will undergo its first cryogenic test at the Massey Test Facility, which now includes a fully assembled BQD. This test will be the first demonstration of the new V3 hardware and ground integration system. If the schedule remains the same, cryogenic testing could be completed by mid-November, followed by engine installation toward the end of the month. Next, the B18 will be moved to Pad 2 for a static fire test, where all of its engines will be fired for the first time. Once completed, it will return to Mega Bay for in-depth inspection and final assembly. Currently, the launch schedule appears to be within reasonable expectations for a year-end launch, at least theoretically. However, the same cannot be said for the ship and ground systems. Launchpad readiness is crucial. Extensive work has been completed on Pad 2, including testing the water flub system, venting, performing quick disconnect operations on the boosters, and conducting a blowdown test. Despite this, SpaceX continues to implement smaller system upgrades. It remains uncertain whether a full-scale engine simulation test will be conducted before the next launch. If such a test is planned, it should be conducted during the cryogenics and engine installation phase of B18 to ensure the launch pad is ready for the main static test planned for December. Given the current pace of progress, it seems likely that a new launch pad will be prepared for the booster test this year. However, the upgrades being implemented, including an advanced orbital launch mount, an improved blowdown, a reinforced fire trench, and an enlarged manifold, are clearly intended for long-term utility. These improvements will lay the foundation for V3 operations and beyond, enabling future Starship models to launch with greater efficiency and safety. Meanwhile, S-39, the spacecraft associated with B-18, continues to make rapid progress. The initial sections were launched in mid-October, with additional sections being delivered and stacked sequentially. The latest information indicates that Section A, containing the rear flaps, is being installed on the entire spacecraft. The next tasks include engine skirt installation and flap installation, followed by a comprehensive system overhaul that includes fuel tank, avionics, and heat shield inspections. Given the existing schedule, S-39 stacking is likely to continue until mid-November. A launch for cryogenic testing could occur later this month, but static fire testing is unlikely to occur before mid-December. After that, the spacecraft will need to undergo a final round of inspections, payload integration, and FTS installation, all of which will likely delay completion until next year. Considering these factors, it's clear that it won't happen before 2026. From one perspective, this setback may seem disappointing. After successful flights 10 and 11, many had hoped SpaceX would end the year on a positive note. the remaining 2.5 months seemed to provide a crucial opportunity to build momentum and demonstrate the capabilities of the V3 system. A missed launch window would also impact the overall schedule. SpaceX has set ambitious goals for 2026, including demonstrating the full capabilities of the V3, reaching orbit, launching a live payload, and attempting a two-stage recovery. Each of these objectives requires its own flight campaign. Any delay now risks shortening next year's schedule, and could delay important goals like developing a refueling system or demonstrating the first uncrewed lunar landing. However, there's another perspective that suggests delays could ultimately be beneficial.
The V3 system is more than just a new experimental phase. It marks the transition from design model to functional capability, taking additional time to ensure the reliability of each system on the ground before the maiden flight can help avoid costly problems later. Careful preparation of the booster system, vehicle, and launch pad will ensure that when V3 lifts off, it will operate with the reliability and accuracy required for the next phase of the program. Furthermore, by officially launching V3 in 2026, SpaceX marks a clear separation between the different development periods. The incremental progress witnessed on V1 and V2 was crucial for gaining knowledge, but V3 is where those insights converge. V3 will feature improved engines, improved design, and efficient ground operations. This smooth transition also paves the way for the more advanced V4 scheduled for 2027. It's important to understand that the launch delay doesn't mean progress has stalled. Behind the scenes, SpaceX is actively ramping up its production capabilities and testing program. Several V3 prototypes are currently under construction, and ground infrastructure development efforts are underway at Starbase and Cape Canaveral. Furthermore, the company remains focused on its Starship HLS initiative, with NASA closely monitoring its every milestone. Therefore, while this delay may prolong the anticipation of another thrilling launch, it ensures that SpaceX is diligently refining the systems that will shape Starship's future. Once Flight 12 successfully demonstrates V3 capabilities, the company will be well-positioned to accelerate testing, enhance its refueling network, and move closer to the first crewed lunar mission. As we look ahead to January 2026, the message is clear. Patience now will pay off in the future. SpaceX is moving into a new phase of Starship development, one built on lessons learned, refined technology, and unwavering determination. If you support their mission, please share your support in the comments by saying, "Let's show it to the world." And as always, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to follow SpaceX's incredible journey to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next one.